did it. We need to talk.
Damn right. Lots for me to explain. But not here. The night's got ears. We can have our talk in your head. You have a room there, right?
How do you know about that?
I'm your grandfather. What don't I know?
This can't be the right way. Overlaps require pieces of art to enter. Is that because of the dark place's focus on art? About my mind place? How is that possible?
We all have the power. Find the truth. Damn right I do. Odin already told you you're a seer. You can gaze into their heads, see the truth. See past the lies. Past this bullshit horror story. Us Andersons aren't bound by it. You can fight it. Don't be the story. Make the story.
It's true. I am a seer. I have a power. My mind place is more than I thought it was. This isn't my intuition. I'm seeing their thoughts. Is this why I know the truth about Logan? While everyone else forgot? You said you were my grandfather. If that's true, why wasn't I told about you?
You were part of our fucked up family, way before this horror story. I was a shitty fucking dad to Freya. Your mom didn't deserve that. Not one bit. Things were said and done. Not a day goes by I haven't regretted it. But that fucking father of yours didn't make things any easier. I know Freya is gone. So I need to apologize to you. I am sorry, Saga.
I can see he's sorry. Mom said she didn't want anything to do with my grandfather. And that my father died before I could remember. It all matches. Thor and Odin aren't part of my family. Mom wouldn't talk about my father. You knew him?
Some doors are better left closed. Your dad was a complicated bastard. Always thinking too many steps ahead. That's not how we work. There was trouble, and then he was gone. I didn't handle it well. Freya didn't want anything to do with me after that. I can't blame her.
I never knew my dad or my mom's family. So many broken relationships in my past. I won't lose mine. With Logan. With David. I won't stop until they're safe. You said you were a shitty father to my mom. Is that why she left?
Freya never looked back. My girl was strong. Freya always thought our powers had a dangerous side. Odin and me did fuck with things that should not have been fucked with. Your mom had common sense. She raised you right. Kept you safe. I'm not surprised she didn't tell you about the Anderson power.
She was always protecting me. Whenever I told my mom about my mind place, she called it make-believe. I wish she'd been more honest with me. At least towards the end. I have the clicker. Can I use it to save my daughter?
An amp? Get your guitar roaring and your drums crashing. Blow reality's eardrums. Just the light switch isn't enough. It's Tom's story we're dealing with, so he's gotta be the one to rewrite it. After that's done, he can flick that switch to bring the whole thing home, baby.
I can't use the clicker without Wake. Tom. Meaning Wake. He needs to rewrite the story first. I can't stop the horror story without him. Thanks for telling me this, Tor. I need to go find Wake to stop this.
The old gods of Asgard will be ready to help. Me and my bro will bring the rock when you need it. Remember, your daughter is alive. Just kept from you by this bullshit horror story.
I needed to hear that. Thanks, Grandpa.
Don't worry about me, kiddo. I'll drag my sorry ass over to Odin. A few shots of the Anderson's finest will fix us both up.
Yeah. The FBC is holding Wake at the sheriff's station. I need to make Agent Estevez understand. They have Wake and I have the clicker. We have to work together to stop this. Get the clicker to Wake and make him fix his attempt to play God. That's the plan. But the FBC have him. The way Tor behaved? I'm surprised my mom hung around for as long as she did. But he is genuinely sorry. Tor and Odin can actually speak with me in my mind place, thanks to their own powers. Tor and Odin are my relatives. The evidence fits with what I know is true. It's a lot to process. Wake wrote Logan into the story. He had no right to use her like this. There is still time to make him fix it. I won't give him a choice. Tor is here, in the overlap. Gotta find him and get the fuck out. Wake needs to be the one to rewrite the ending. And I'll need to keep an eye on him. The story doesn't affect me like it does other people. Because of who I am. Because of my family. It's not opening.
When Cynthia Weaver was downstairs at breakfast, Rose snuck into her room. With all the lamps in the room, it took her a while to find the one with an angel. Luckily, the dream Alan had sent her had been very clear. Rose was certain that Cynthia would not miss one lamp. She had so many. Tonight, Rose would put the lamp in a shoebox and let it sink into the garden pond. That's what Alan wanted. That's how she could help him. The thought made her whole body buzz with joy. Cynthia knew the lamp was missing the very moment she came back to her room. She was overcome by grief. It had been Tom's lamp, one of the few things that reminded her of him. It had not worked in a long time with the cord severed and the light switch gone. But there are other kinds of lights than the ones we can see. The invisible light of the angel lamp had held Cynthia together all these years. With tears welling in her eyes, she didn't see the shadows shifting in the corners of her room.
Next, we had a guest lined up. I have it written down here somewhere. What's this say? Jim Figamore. Figamore. I know that name from somewhere, but...
Every night was bingo night at the Valhalla Nursing Home. Each time Rose drew a ball from the cage and called out its number, some of the residents shouted bingo, no matter what was on their cards. Some of them sat mute, their cards full, never calling out. Some of them would try to steal the ball from her. Some of them would chastise the others for acting out. It was like herding a clowder of cats. Rose didn't mind. She liked cats. She knew she was where she was supposed to be, with her little Vikings, waiting for the hero to come. Tonight, the residents were restless, more so than usual. Ati was wearing Blum's coveralls again. Tor stood by the phone. Too late. Rose saw the hammer in his hand. The garden lights started to flicker, the darkness and rain pressing against the windows. The time drew nigh.
See, people were calling in about Wendy Davis going missing, but it sounds like they have her confused with this Alan Walker fellow you're talking about. Terry, you were there last Sunday at the market selling those cuckoo clocks when I came to visit, remember? Pat? No.
Another cult stash? That's all of them.
Espresso! Down! Carnival of music!
The 81st annual Deer Fest was just around the corner. Everyone in Bright Falls was bustling. There were banners to be hung, pies baked, deer masks sold. Bright Falls had made the top 100 American small town lists for its modest, rustic charm. The town expected a lot of tourists this year, but a shadow hung over the Deer Fest preparations. The forecast promised rain. Fearful whispers promised more murders. The police were on high alert. Sheriff Breaker had deputies patrolling the streets at night. Bright Falls was no stranger to odd happenings, but to cancel Deer Fest? Out of the question. The townsfolk were anxious, their anticipation mixed with fear. People had restless dreams. The lights seemed dimmer. Floodwater pressed in on the town, and the shadows poured in with it.
I'm never gonna get used to this. More of those rhymes. Doesn't make sense. No. Nah. think, Saga. Nope. Keep trying. That's not right. Doesn't look right. No. Nah. Think, Saga. Yeah. They're all so soft and sad. A charm. Perfect for my bracelet. There's another cult stash. Oh, another rhyme. Nope. That's not right. Oh, shit.
Anxious. winning!
Lots of charms lying around here. Another one of those lunchboxes.
Rose woke up from another dream from her idol. Another message. All through her morning routine, she was humming happily. So happily, she realized she was starting to forget what Alan had told her. Something about a hero who would come to save them all. And the hero... Rose frowned. This won't do, Rose Marigold. You know better than to forget. Something about knitwear. The hero... liked it? Rose nodded, determined. She'd use the knitwork to guide the hero to the secret stashes she had hid in the forest to help them. Knitwear to mark the spot. Alan will love that, she thought. Now she only needed the knitwork. Rose thought hard. Mandy May was always knitting. Mandy May would help her.
it's not broadcasting. That green light is supposed to be red.
Yeah, which light?
This one here. Donna's grandson wrote down instructions for me, but I can't for the life of me remember where I put them.
You sure you're not up here?
Yeah, green means off, red means on. Or was it?
Another one of those rhymes. Right. A charm for my bracelet.
those people just burst in here and expect others to clean up after them.
Another one of those cult boxes.
The fishes are biting again. I didn't like all that hubbub earlier. Poor things.
Okie dokie. I don't like the sounds coming from the station. I've seen some crazy things in my life. I don't know.
Power's out. Always a good sign. There's Taken inside. Holding cells. Is that where they're keeping Wake? Door is locked, though. I don't have the key. Anyone here?
I'm here. In the closet.
Agent Estevez? Is that you?
Anderson? Didn't I tell you to fuck off?
Looks like it's a good thing I didn't.
Looks like. My leg's busted, so I'm gonna need your help. Listen, there is a person out there with you invaded by something that we call the Shadow, and if you don't...
Taken. Yeah, I'll handle it. All clear, Estevez. That leg doesn't look good.
Feels even worse. But thanks for saving the rest of me. We should talk.
What happened here?
Where to fucking start? We came to check out a system alert at Cauldron Lake, but it's worse than we could handle. Real boondoggle. The police, my own agents, most were invaded before we could even react.
Have you found my partner, Agent Casey?
Yeah, we found him. Out in the woods. He had a close encounter with the Shadow, and it did something to him.
Is he okay?
He's alive. We took him down to the morgue for an examination. Haven't heard anything since the attack.
What did the FBC come here to do?
Bright Falls is the site of a recurring altered world event. The shadow is stronger than we expected. We're low on resources, problems at HQ. But we do have equipment for dealing with the shaded threat. We were just caught off guard before we could set it up.
Where is Wake? I know what's going on here. Wake can fix this.
Alan Wake is a para-utilitarian. The word's a mouthful, so you know it's serious. We have him locked up in the holding cells per protocol. He's connected to the shadow in some way.
Estevez, I need to see Wake. How do I get into the cell block?
Okay. Protocols don't mean that much at this point anyway. Don't make me regret this, Anderson. Until the power's back on, the door to the holding cells won't open. There's a fuse box downstairs in the basement. Here. You'll need these keys.
Back into the morgue, huh? Fantastic. Makes sense. The cell door won't open without power.
Did you read me, Anderson?
I read you. Have you had Alf frequency this entire time?
Eavesdropping is a big part of the job. But no, I got it from your partner. Anderson, look for a fuse to replace the blown out one in the fuse box. That should get the power going again.
Yeah. On it.
Thank you.
another cult stash?
Casey! Is that you?
Anderson?
Hold your fire! I'm coming in!
Hey, Anderson. Like what I've done with the place?
Could use a bit more light.
Funny.
How are you holding up?
Don't give me that worried look, Anderson. It's a flesh wound. Gave me a chance to have a nice chat about ex-wives with Kieran. Agent Estevez, I mean.
Making new friends, huh? I'm jealous. Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. What's the situation on your end?
What happened at the hotel?
Wake was telling the truth about the cult being after him. The thing, the dark presence, it's real, too. I saw it. A fucked up monster cloud. Wake tried to warn me. It knocked me out. FBC found me in the woods later.
Watery turned out to be a good lead. Found the clicker and the cult. But the horror story's changing reality. Like Wake said it would. Logan, she's, the story claims she died here. But we can stop it.
Wait, Saga. What do you, Logan is gone. She has been. For a long time.
Casey's affected by the horror story, too. I'm fighting for them all now. I'm gonna fix this, Casey. You, Logan, all of it. I just need to get the power back on first.
Yeah, give him hell, Anderson. Just remember, some things in life can't be fixed with a light switch. As for the power problem, here. I found a fuse on those poor bastards there.
I'll take care of it. Stay put, Casey. I'll let you know when it's safe.
I'm not going anywhere.
Anderson, good news, bad news. You can get to the cell block now, but the shaded hostiles that were in there are on the loose.
Thanks for the heads up.
Die!
We're coming down.
Situation is under control, Estevez. Coming back up.
Copy.
Over here. Behind the counter. Got a little cramped in that closet.
An electrical lock system with no failsafe. Smart. Is the FBC sending any help?
We were the help. Well, us in the lake house. But we still have bureau gear specifically engineered to fight this threat. It's stored in the back lot. We were setting it up when the Taken interrupted us. We have light arrays, a containment cell, etc., etc. We are not out of this fight yet.
What's at the lake house?
It's a bureau research facility at Cauldron Lake set up to study the effects of this AWE. When I got into town, I went there for backup. The whole station is lost, taken by the Shadow. Lost a lot of agents. Barely got out myself.
What's going on?
Well, I had a hell of a time avoiding those Taken. Ended up back here. Anyway, I wanted to warn you that we have the Koskula brothers in the cells as well. They're the ringleaders of the Cult of the Tree. Don't let your guard down.
I'm not done here yet. Come on, Saga. Time to get back to work.
Saga! Fucking FBI, FBC, you government fucks all fucking this up for us! Let us the fuck out!
You're the leaders of the cult. You're not going anywhere. I'm sure Sheriff Braco wouldn't mind me borrowing this.
Wake will ruin everything. Get rid of him, Saga. You fucking shot me. Typical government stooge. Let me out so I can kill him, that fucker. You come to our town and act like you know what you're dealing with, but you have no fucking... You can't stop it. None of you can. We can take care of this. We've been preparing for this.
To find the key.
Saga, do you have it?
You wrote Logan into the story. You told me yourself from the dark place.
Listen, Scratch is coming. He's close. He's almost here.
My daughter is dead because of you. She's a child. What the fuck is wrong with you?
I'm trying to fix this. I will fix this. I'll save everyone, but we're running out of time. I need the clicker.
Need the key. I have the clicker. You will fix this. You will save my daughter. Promise me.
Yes, I promise. But we're out of time. Hurry!
Don't fucking give it to him! Let him get him! He's a fucking monster, Saga! There it is. We've been waiting for you, motherfucker! I'm gonna fucking destroy you!
Thank you.
Only one left. Doing great.
Scratches Wake's double. He tricked us. He almost got the clicker from me. The whole plan has gone out the window. How could we get this so wrong?
Textbook boondoggle.
You said it, Anderson. It's a shit show. So what's the plan?
The FBC usually handles stuff like this, right? Any thoughts?
Hold up. You brought a paranatural object in here without telling me and then almost handed it over to a hostile entity?
I didn't know if I could trust you. That was a mistake. So was believing Scratch. But it's not too late. I just need to understand more.
You got that right. Let's start acting like we're on the same side, yeah?
The horror story is changing reality. It made it so my daughter died here, even though she's supposed to be back home in Virginia. Do you know if that's...
AWEs are localized distortions of reality. The area outside town might not be affected. Sometimes they expand, sometimes they fizzle out. If we can make sure it's the latter, your kid might be fine.
The whole thing is a nightmare. I can't let my family be torn apart.
Having family isn't easy in this line of work. The late nights, travel, alternate realities threatening their existence. My ex-wife couldn't take it.
Karen, you're better off without her. I know I am.
Scratch pretended to be Wake to trick us.
He almost won me over. I should have trusted my gut. I had a bad feeling about him when we found him at the lake. When that insane monster cloud came at me in the woods, I saw a face inside it. Wake's. I think he was always a monster. Always Scratch.
So tell me what I'm missing. The FBC must know something.
Good news, we have Bureau intel on all of this. Bad news, it's highly classified. Good news, consider yourself deputized into the Federal Bureau of Control. Here's a key to the cell where we keep the files. Happy reading.
Okay. Thanks. Go team.
One more thing, the lake house. I didn't give you all the details earlier, but now that you're part of the team, I can really let loose. Misery loves company.
What happened at the lake house? You really don't remember Logan living in Virginia with me and David?
I remember you and David having problems. You needed a break. You and Logan moved to Watery and then Logan, well, that awful thing happened. After you came back to work, I thought you'd be the perfect partner for this case, if you were willing to return to the area.
Okay, that's enough. The story is changing your memories. What you're remembering is fiction. Logan is alive. I'm not divorced. We never moved here. I remember the truth.
No. Wake or Scratch, whoever that was, said the story could be used to attack us. We all need to question what's real. With that said, how do we know the story isn't giving you false hope?
I can't convince them. I just need to change the story. The dark presence is vulnerable against bright light. At least that makes sense. Doesn't make sense. I never did any of these things. It's like some bad soap opera version of my life. I can tell something is wrong. What's happening to Casey?
I'm a goner. Swell. A shadow crawling under my skin. In my head. Call my ex. Tell her I'm sorry. Terminal. Case. Casey.
Something is wrong with him. He's hurt worse than he says. He's scared. Scratch was pretending to be Wake. Manipulating me. What does he want from me? No. I'm in control here. It's my mind place. He's powerful. Too powerful. Just his presence here makes me feel sick. Like a wave of terror through my head. I feel his single-minded drive to get the clicker. Assumed Wake escaped the dark place. Is it possible he's still there?
The big apple in an ocean of darkness. Gone diving. Note from my editor. You're using the wrong tense. Trapped in a loop. My friends will meet him when I'm gone.
Wake is still trapped in the dark place. Maybe he always was.
Thank you.
kind of case my ex hated. The ones that might kill me.
That's funny. The cases that might kill me were my ex's favorite.
The cult didn't trust Wake. Or is it Scratch? Wake isn't the first person the Dark Presence disguised itself as. Is a gateway to the dark place. What the hell is a para-utilitarian? The clicker amplifies any changes to reality suggested by a piece of art. Makes them permanent. I need to know what information I can still trust. Okay. Wake is trapped in the dark place. He's been reaching out, communicating with me in the overlaps. Wake told me the clicker would fix this. But Wake was actually Scratch. How can I trust anything he said?
The artist must conclude his work. He rides a storm on your piece. Wake up and smell the danger. We told you already, kiddo. What Tom said about the light switch is true. Don't let the story confuse you. You need him to write the ending you want. The clicker can make that ending come true.
But we don't have Wake. Everything we knew about the clicker was true. He wasn't lying. Scratch told me the clicker can be used to change the story. Does that match your understanding of this thing?
Yeah, the light switch is a paranatural item, maybe even an object of power. We have verified reports that Alan Wake was in possession of it during the AWE here back in 2010. It definitely has power. We know that much.
I can come up with a plan. I always do. The clicker can fix this, but I can't use it without Wake. Tor knows about this stuff. Maybe he can help. Wake is still in the dark place. How do I get him out?
We live and breathe rock and roll. From the silence of screams, from the fever of dreams. The clicker can amp up other works of art, not just Tom's writing. Anything created with passion. The dark power of the lake will make it creep into reality. But if the holder of the clicker believes in the art, they can make it all come true in the flick of a switch.
I can use the clicker without Wake. Only Wake's writing can change the horror story. But I can use the clicker to change something else. Like getting Wake out of the dark place. I will use the clicker to change reality and bring Wake back at Cauldron Lake. I'll need the right work of art, but that won't be a problem. I've got it now. I just need to tell the others what to do and fix everything. For good. So we need Wake to fix the story, right? That hasn't changed. So here's what I have. Wake's still trapped in the dark place, under the lake. I think we can use the clicker to get him out. But first, we need a work of art. Something other than his story. And that'll get him here.
I'm not filling out the paperwork for this one. I wouldn't know where to start. But I'm sold.
Okay. Look, this feels like something that once we get the ball rolling, there's no turning back. You sure you have it all figured out?
Not just yet. Give me a moment.
Okay, Anderson. You let me know when you're ready.